Hello and welcome to another tutorial. Today we're going to be learning about masking and layer clipping. Let's jump right in. As you can see, we have two shapes here. Shape on the left is a blue square and the shape on the right is a pink circle. If you look in the layers panel, you can see the blue square is on top and the pink circle is underneath. I want to place this square inside of this circle, but I want the circle to act as a kind of mask so I can't see the whole of the square. I'll demonstrate for you. Click and drag so the square is lying over the circle. In the layers panel, click on the square and click drag down and to the right, and you can see now, if I let go, you can see now that the circle is kind of acting like a mask and this blue square is being clipped to the circle. You can see that now that the square is inside of the circle, that it is now a child layer of the main circle shape. So if I select this layer, I can move it around and you can see that they're both moving together. The square has been clipped to this shape. This is called layer clipping. Now, if I want to move this square inside the circle, I simply go to the layers panel and I select the square, which is called rectangle on this, because I made it with the rectangular tool. And I can click on it and drag it around to reposition wherever I choose. This can also be done in the reverse order. Let me demonstrate. Okay, now I want the circle to go inside the boundaries of this square. We'll do exactly the same thing. Just make sure the circle is on top, lay it over the square. All right, now on the layers panel, we click and drag down and to the right, and there. Now you can see that the circle is clipped to the boundaries of this square. Again, in the layers panel, I can move around the circle wherever I choose. And if I click up here on the main shape, which is now the square, I can move it around and you can see they're both moving together in unison. That's layer clipping. Okay, now masking. Now I want to use the pink circle as a mask to reveal different parts of this square. So again, we're going to click and drag it so it's overlapping the square. And in the layers panel, click on the circle and drag it down. And this time, instead of dragging it down and right like before, remember that's what happened before, this time we're going to click and drag down, and we're going to, you see this slight bit here is highlighted just to the right of the square in the layers panel. I'm going to let go now. You see there's two layers. This layer at the top is the square, and the layer at the bottom is the mask. Now that mask is the circle like we talked about. If I click and drag, I can reveal different parts of the square that the circle is masking. Or if I click on the main, on the square shape here, you can see it's created the child layer underneath. I can drag it around and they both move together. That's called masking. So you've probably noticed down here in the, underneath the layers panel, there's a button called mask layer. We're going to use that right now. First off, I'm going to drag the square so it's overlapping the circle. The square has been selected. If you go down and click the mask layer, you can see now underneath the square, there is now another child layer called mask. The next thing we want to do is head on over to the fill tool, click on that, and we're going to click and drag across like so. Now you'll notice that on one side I have white and the other is gray. If I select black for this side, for the gray side, you can see that it's making it more transparent on one side, and the white is revealing more of the blue color. And you can fiddle around with it however you please. Right now, you can see that on top, you can see type, it says linear. That means it's a straight line from opaque to transparent. I can change this. You can see the solid, elliptical, radial. Let's just click one of the other ones. Elliptical. I can drag it, move it around, and you can see how it's changing the look of this square. So that's what that button does. Okay. Also, there is another way to go about this. Let's go back. Okay, I want to make this transparent on one side, and I want to reveal a little bit more of the pink circle underneath. If we head over to the transparency tool, click on that, and make sure you've selected the square, I can simply click and drag out. So that's using the transparency tool. Again, you can change the type to anything you want. Let's go conical this time. Okay, everything's black here. Let's add, if I double click there, and I will make this more opaque. Sorry, I'll bring the opacity down. You can see it's revealing more of the circle underneath. I'm going to add another one here just to demonstrate. Oops, sorry. Here we go. I can drag this all the way to 100%. You can see how it changes. So the white's revealing the color underneath and the shape, and the black is concealing it. If I just add another one here and make sure it's up to 100%, so the black's hiding all of that. Okay, so that's layer clipping and masking. We've played around with a couple of shapes here. Let's throw a photo into the mix. So let me zoom out a little bit. I've got a photo I took here whilst I was on holiday. Let's get rid of the square. Okay, you can see here in the layers panel, the circle is on top, the photo is underneath. I want to put the, I want to stick the circle over this portion of the boat, and I want to clip the photo inside of the circle. So in the layers panel, select the image and click and drag up and to the right. There, now you can see that if I select this portion of the main shape, the circle, you can see now the child layer is the image. And again, I can drag it around. If I was making a document, maybe I could put it there and add some text on this side. You can see they're moving around together. If I want to select a different portion of the boat, I simply head to the layers panel, click on the image, and I can move the image around to reveal whichever part of the boat I wish. So, the image is now clipped inside of this shape, and it's clipped to the boundaries of the circle, as you can see. Let's now use this circle as a mask. And again, circles on top, fishing boats underneath. Click and drag the circle down. And this time we're going to drag it there, just to the right of the image you see in the layers panel. I'll let go. Now, if I select the mask, you can see now I can move around the circle around the image instead of moving the image around within the circle. So now I'm just revealing different parts that I like. And selecting the full shape, you see, again, it's not moving around. I can place it wherever I want on the document, and again, we can add whatever we want. So that's layer clipping and masking. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to keep seeing more of these videos, please press like, hit subscribe, and smash that notification bell.